Hi there, Doug Stimmel with IT Creations. Today I have the Supermicro Hyper Server 221H-TNR. As part of Supermicro's Hyper Super Server family, this platform is highly configurable and high performance for applications in data centers, uses an enterprise server, AI inference and machine learning, and more. It offers support for 4th and 5th generation Intel Xeon scalable CPUs, plus high-end double-width GPUs. Click that subscribe button if you want to see more reviews of the latest and not so latest servers and professional workstations. Let's get to it. It can also be outfitted with Intel's Xeon CPU Max series CPUs, featuring high bandwidth memory. As such, this system runs one of Supermicro's X13 motherboards for support of those CPU families I just mentioned. There's actually two versions of this system, the 221H-TNR we have today and the 221H-TN24R. This system comes standard with 8 hot swap NVMe SAS SATA drive bays, but will take an additional 8 hot swap NVMe SAS SATA drive bays for up to 16 drive bays total. The 221H-TN24R can support up to 24 hot swap NVMe SAS SATA drive bays. Slightly different power requirements too, but we'll get to that. With 8-bay configuration of the 221H-TNR, we installed 6 U.3 NVMe drives offering 15.36 terabytes each for up to 92 terabytes total. If we were to install the optional drive cage for 8 more bays, it would go to the left of the center cage next to the control panel. That small control panel has a power on button, unit ID button with LED, and then some telltales for power, HDDs, NIC2, NIC1, power, and universal information. Basically system status. Are you interested in the Supermicro Hyper Server 221H-TNR? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system that you can configure or one that's listed at IT Creations with a value of $5,000 or more. Just click that link for more information. When you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. It's just as simple as that to save. ITCreations.com. On the back panel, there can be up to 8 PCIe slots. There are several options for wattage on the PSUs depending on the configuration. That 221-TN24R has the option for one more at up to 1600 watts. No integrated LAN ports, but there is an integrated MLAN port for remote management of the system. Below that, dual USB 2.0 ports, a VGA port, and then two advanced I/O module OCP 3.0 slots for network communications. Currently, the system is outfitted with an OCP card offering two 10 gigabit RJ45 ports, plus an additional quad port card in the PCI slots with four RJ45 ports, also at 10 gigabit per second. Let's take a look inside. Supermicro provides several management utilities to help administrators manage the system. Supermicro Server Manager, or SSM, for managing Supermicro servers and a data center. It provides an all-in-one solution with a graphical user interface. Licensing is required for each target node, but you can manage up to 10,000 nodes. That'd be for Linux. There's also the IPMI Redfish interface, or you could go with SuperDoctor 5, SD5, which is really for a single server or small cluster. There are a bunch of other utilities for managing, provisioning, and monitoring, but we're pretty much focusing on the hardware today. It would take way too long to get into all the other aspects of management. Maybe another video. In addition to that upfront storage, there are dual PCIe 3.0 x 2 SATA 3 hybrid M.2 slots on the system board that can be used to support the OS in a RAID 1 for redundancy. The installed premium virtual RAID on CPU key or VRAW key provides RAIDs of 0, 1, 5, or 10 for NVMe storage devices. The only difference between the premium and standard VRAW key is the addition of RAID 5. There is another VRAW key that can support RAID 5 too, but that one can only be used with Intel SSDs. This platform is configured with dual 4th gen Intel Xeon Scalable Gold 5418N CPUs with 24 cores, operating at 1.8 GHz, turbo boost of 3.8 GHz, 45 megabits of L3 cache, and a thermal design power rating, or TDP, of 165 watts. These are paired with 16 gigabyte memory modules with 8 per CPU for up to 256 gigabytes of DDR5 memory, operating at speeds of up to 4,000 megahertz. At capacity, the system can provide up to 8 terabytes of memory with 256 gigabyte memory modules in all 32 slots and memory speeds of up to 5,600 megatransfers per second. Our installed 4th gen Gold CPUs are only capable of memory speeds of 4,000 megatransfers per second, but like I said, it will support Intel Xeon CPU Max and 5th gen Intel Xeon Scalable processors. With 4th gen Intel Xeon Scalable processors, you get up to 60 physical cores and 120 virtual threads, plus memory speeds of up to 4800 megatransfers per second with one DIMM per channel. That would be with some other gold or platinum CPUs. Installing 5th gen Intel Xeon scalable processors, you can add 4 more cores for up to 64 physical cores and 128 virtual threads, plus a bump in memory speeds to 5600 megatransfers per second, also with one DIMM per channel. Each of these CPU generations support 8-channel memory architecture. There are definite improvements with the 5th generation CPUs across all categories, which I will add Intel flip-flops between comparing the 5th gen CPUs against the 4th gen and 3rd gen versions. Makes it confusing.
Stronger, faster.
I mean, it shouldn't be that surprising that the 5th gen CPUs are better, stronger, faster than the previous generation. At this point, we have Intel Xeon 6. Not going there yet until we have a system and one of those to review. The Intel Xeon CPU Max series is the only x86 processor with high bandwidth memory designed to accelerate high performance computing and AI workloads. Maybe I should have saved the $6 million man spoof for this CPU. Then again, maybe not. These are still considered 4th gen CPUs, but they do allow your applications to run in different memory modes. HBM only, HBM flat mode, and HBM cache mode. High bandwidth memory offers lower power consumption and a small form factor with a dense stacked memory configuration and high speed interface. No, I'm not getting into that either. Just know that you can support Compute Express Link 1.1, also known as CXL 1.1. CXL is an alternate protocol and will run off the same PCIe physical layer on the system board. It allows both standard PCIe devices and CXL devices on the same link so you don't have to give up one for the other. Let's move on. All three of those processor series support PCIe 5.0 bandwidth, which is twice the bandwidth compared to PCIe 4.0, which was the limit for 3rd gen Intel Xeon scalable CPUs. Each CPU also supports 80 PCIe 5.0 with CXL lanes for 160 lanes total with both processors installed. The system can be configured with up to 8 PCIe 5.0 by 8 slots or 4 PCIe 5.0 by 16 slots for expansion. Those expansion slots can be used for NICs, storage controllers, and GPUs. The hyperserver will accept up to 4 double-wide or 4 single-wide GPUs, including the H100 with 80 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory at the top of the stack. But with the H100, only 3 can be installed. It features Hopper architecture and is the only one of the bunch that also demands a PCIe 5.0 by 16 bus interface and draws 300 to 350 watts of power from a 16-pin power connector. There are several power connectors scattered around the system board towards the back of the chassis. This system is currently outfitted with 4x16 PCIe 5.0 slots and features an Ada Lovelace architecture NVIDIA L40S graphics card with 40 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory with ECC. It's a professional graphics card with 76,300 million transistors and a few other impressive stats you can see here. It too requires a 16-pin power connector, but a PCIe 4.0 by 16 slot and draws 300 watts of power maximum. It also has one HDMI 2.1 port and 3 DisplayPort 1.48 outputs, which we won't be using as this system will be rack mounted. With 568 tensor cores, this GPU is an excellent card for machine learning and AI inference, but also video rendering and 3D graphics enhanced by DLSS or deep learning supersampling. Offering high performance attributes typical of Supermicro's Hyper Super Server lineup, the 221H-TNR delivers on that with dual 4th, 5th, or Xeon CPU Max Series CPUs and support for up to 8 terabytes of memory. Doesn't hurt that it can take a few high-end graphics cards either. Subscribe to our channel if you want to see more server and workstation reviews. I'm quite sure I'll be getting one of those servers outfitted with Intel Xeon 6 6700 CPUs very soon. Then we get to look at E cores and P cores. If you have any questions on this platform or any others, leave a message in the comments section below. For more information on this system, click that link or one in the description below to visit IT Creations. ITCreations.com for all your IT hardware needs. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and you're not.